I want to just ask you about Britain's military performance in Iraq in the 4 years since Saddam failed. I ask this question because I look at the American situation, and within weeks of arriving, they had a Sunni insurgency. Within 3 months of arriving, they had mass casualty al-Qaeda truck bombings, the blowing up of the UN, the Red Cross, all of those things. So they started with a bad situation, and clearly they've still got a pretty bad security situation in Baghdad or Anbar. The British started with a pretty good situation in Basra and now have a bad one, in which we're losing something in the region of two or three soldiers a week at the moment. It's a very, very intense and violent situation now in Basra. Are you still confident that the UK knows what it's doing in counterinsurgency? Does what's happened in Iraq in some way cause you to question the UK approach? Or is it all about bigger issues, that the overall question of resources, how many battalions could be allocated, the American approach to the whole political peace in Iraq? Is it all about those bigger issues, or does it cause you to wonder whether Britain should revamp its doctrines in those kind of situations?
Yes, it's a very, not a very profound question, actually. First problem is we are not setting the overall policy because we are the junior or one-off. Don't forget there are another 20-odd nations, 24, I think it is still involved, but we are the second. But we are not, at the end of the day, setting the policy, although we have people in at all levels to put our own point of view. So coalition warfare is not easy. You've only got to go back to the Alanbrooke Diaries, and it's all there. It's all there, and there's nothing new under this particular sun. I think the British Army is not bad. Let me go no further than that. At reflecting, saying, have we got anything to learn from this? Do we need to change? We have in southern Iraq gone up and down in terms of profile a hell of a lot, depending on the situation. We have not had Sunni Shia, I mean, it's obscene violence. They just want to kill as many of each other as they can, and women and children, doesn't matter a damn. I mean, anything will do. We have not had that in the south because, of course, it's very, very largely Shia. We have had somewhat baleful influence from across the border, and a lot of jockeying for position. Part of this is how strong is the government in Baghdad? Not as much as one would like, perhaps. But that is not to deny, and maybe there are people in this room who were present. I wasn't, sadly, on each of the 3 or 4 occasions when Iraq went to the polls. And the international observers said pretty much it was, a bit rough and ready, but something they hadn't done. Free polls. And people who were there said the atmosphere was quite extraordinary. So, one shouldn't necessarily just write the whole place off. I think that would be extremely unwise and very premature. Because again, the lid that came off the pressure cooker, the lid which Saddam Hussein had screwed down, just as Tito had screwed it down. And you have these old enmities just absolutely bubbling up. Now I hope. Did we get it wrong, I think, is what you're asking me. Well, if we did, quite a large number of Britain's best senior commanders didn't get it. And I don't believe that is the case. I mean, we are hugely fortunate in having a very experienced army with highly professional people, and in particular those senior leaders who are everything. And, I just don't think that if there was some other solution which was missed, that somebody somewhere hadn't thought of it. We are in a very difficult and complex situation in Iraq.